Hey brothers and sisters, this is Francis Santa Rose coming on to do a short video today, and I really didn't plan on doing one again. I just wanted to pray and go to the gym, and there's something going on today. I don't know what it is. I have never been so distracted praying in my life. Normally, I just get into it, I'm in it, I go in deep, I'm fine. There's really no distractions, there's nothing. I've been able to focus at all. I don't know what it is. There's something going on in the spirit realm today. Today is 9/11, and I'm here to tell you that there's something happening in the spirit realm. I don't know if it's going to manifest in the natural realm today. It may not, but there's something happening in the spiritual realm. There's attack going on. Normally, I don't give a lot of a credence to demonic attack because I understand our authority. We just take authority over it and it's gone. And I got to tell you, it's relentless. It's really interesting. So, you know, we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. We are an authority. No weapon formed against us shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against us, we take authority over and we condemn. We do it. We have authority to condemn it in the name of Jesus. So, I felt like reading out of Timothy today, the second epistle of Timothy. And I'm just going to start reading because Lord put this on my heart because of where we are and what we're doing. He said, read here. And there's just bits and pieces that are popping off the page at me. Paul starts out in the beginning. He says, I remind you. So he's reminding them to stir up the gifts of God, which is in you through the laying on of my hands. So he's going to lay hands on them to stir up these gifts. You know, what we know the gifts of God are healing, prophecy, words of knowledge, words of wisdom, tongues. I mean, these are all gifts of the Holy Spirit. So he's encouraging them to stir up the gifts. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. That's really important. If any of y'all feel it, write in and let me know. Anybody who's like sensing what I'm talking about, because like I said, it's stronger today than I've ever felt it. I don't know if there's something going on today. So let me know. I want to hear. But we know we don't have a spirit of fear, so it's nothing to be afraid of, but just to be like you're on guard and taking authority over it and being active. You know, what does it say? Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, roams about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. He can only devour us if we do nothing, if we don't take authority, and we let him. You know, if we do nothing, he takes authority, we get devoured. If we take authority, and if we are sober, you know, not drunk, the opposite of drunk, if we're vigilant, not lazy, if we're sober and vigilant, we'll take authority because we'll see it coming. You know, it's like right here, I'm sitting here, and I notice there's something going on. So I'm going to take authority over it. Make sense? All right, it says, we don't have a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind in the name of Jesus. He said, do not be ashamed of the testimony of our Lord. Now, obviously, who's going to do that? For our Savior, Jesus Christ, who has abolished death and brought life and immortality to light, through the gospel, to which I was appointed to preach, appointed a preacher, an apostle, and a teacher of the Gentiles. For I know whom I have believed, and I am am persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed to him until that day. Gosh, I feel like I can't even talk either. I can't read, I can't talk. What's going on? You therefore must endure hardship as a good soldier in Christ. Yeah, I'm pretty much sure that I'm speaking to everybody here. We've gone through hardship, but what does he say here? He says, you must endure hardship as a good soldier to Christ. It's going to happen. You know, what does it say in Peter? He says, don't think it's strange when you fall into these fiery trials. It like some strange thing has happened. Oh, what is going on? You know, this is normal. If you're a good soldier, you're going to be under attack. You are. But, you know, we've been given authority. We've been given power. You know, not that we fold under the attack, but just that we got to recognize it and take, and you know, and step up and do our job. He says, so you must endure hardship as a good soldier, for no one engaged in warfare entangles himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who enlisted him as a soldier. So our job is to work for God and not to be caught up in the world and the things of the world and what's going on in the world. We got to be on our job. This is a never-ending job. This thing doesn't stop. You don't take... We don't get vacations. We don't get to take breaks from this. This is not something that we can say, hey, let's go on vacation. And while we're on vacation, we don't do anything regarding spiritual warfare, regarding our relationship with our Father. It's not like that. We don't ever get a vacation from this. We're soldiers at war. You know, a soldier at war doesn't, in the middle of battle, say, you know what, I'm going to go sit down over there and have a sandwich and a little coffee break while his brothers are up there on the edge fighting and shooting and engaging in warfare. It's not like that. We don't get that luxury. And also, if anyone competes in athletics, he is not crowned unless he competes according to the rules. The hardworking farmer must be first to part. Look at me, I can't even read today. I can read. I promise you I can read. I really can. I promise. My mother taught me how to read. The hardworking farmer must be first to partake of the crops. Consider what I say, and may the Lord give you understanding in all things. But the word of God is not chained. For if we died with him, we shall also live with him. If we endure, we shall also reign with him. I like that. If we endure, we will reign with Jesus. I kind of like that a lot. But if we deny him, he will deny us. And this one is interesting. If we are faithless, he remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. I like that. I like that. For anybody that thinks that they don't have enough faith, you do, because he's faithful. Be diligent to present yourselves approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, but shun and profane idle babblings. And I think this was really important. This one really came off the page at me. For they will increase with more ungodliness. So we're going to find that as we get closer to the end, this kind of stuff is going to increase. It's going to happen, but it's going to happen more often, more frequently. And then he gives kind of an example here. He says, their message will spread like cancer. And then he lists two people. Hymenaeus and Philetus are of this sort. They have strayed concerning the truth, saying that the resurrection is already passed and they've overthrown the faith. So it was like, what do you call it? Idle, profane and idle babblings. All right. He says, watch out for that stuff. Stay away from it. Just stay away from it. Nevertheless, the solid foundation of God stands, having this seal. The Lord knows those who are his. Hey, the Lord knows those who are his. I like that. Flee youthful lusts, but pursue righteousness, faith, love, peace with those who call on the Lord out of a pure heart. So try in as much as possible. And I know that some of you, because I read every post, some of you are like you're out there on an island. You got nobody. You know, nobody around you is saved. You're doing it all by yourself. But in as much as is possible, surround yourself with like-minded believers. And if you don't have any physical bodies of people, then I guess, you know, get online to some of your people that you're subscribed to and fellowship, because a lot of those people that write in, man, they're awesome brothers and sisters, and they'll encourage you and they'll pray for you. And you know, look, what the devil intended for evil in the internet, God can use for good. And there's a lot of great fellowship, man. I get some of the most encouraging comments that, man, they just bless the heck out of me. All right. He says, avoid foolish and ignorant disputes, knowing that they only generate strife. A servant of the Lord must not quarrel, but be gentle to all. This is really interesting, because what I sense is that as we get closer to the end, there's going to be these aggravating demons that are going to try and start fights between you and family members, and you and friends, and you and brothers and sisters, believers and unbelievers, just little nagging little to get you out, to get you into sin, where they can bring in then condemnation. You know, you've fallen short, you're not worthy. He says, avoid all such things. A servant of the Lord must not quarrel, but be gentle to all, able to teach, patient, in humility, correcting those who are in opposition, if God perhaps will grant them repentance, so that they may know the truth, and that they may come to their senses and escape the snare of the devil. Now listen to this. He says, if God perhaps will grant them repentance. So when you're talking to, and he's talking about debating somebody about, you know, about the cross. But if you're talking to somebody and they reject it, don't start a fight with them about it. Just drop it, because God's the one who's going to grant them the repentance and open their eyes of understanding. It's not your job. You know, you present the gospel and let the Holy Spirit do the rest. But don't fight or argue or quarrel with them about it. He says that they may come to their senses and escape the snare of the devil, having been taken captive by him to do his will. So they were taken captive by the devil to do his will. So try and have really almost, it's almost like a pity. You know, don't get mad, don't get offended. And when they lash out at you, you know, their father is talking through them. It's not them. You know, if they say something ugly, I was having a conversation with a former brother, sister in Christ the other day. And I say former because they're gone. And this is one of the sweetest persons I've ever met in my entire life. Just salt of the earth, sweet, just the kindest, sweetest, filled with the Holy Spirit, anointed, gentle, peaceable. And what was coming out of the mouth was vulgarity and crudeness and a rejection and hatred and anger and vile and despicable. And it was, oh my gosh, I couldn't believe it. And I just tried to respond with love. And, you know, just like he says here, you know, what do you say? He says, but pursue righteousness, faith, love, peace, and peace. And it was like, I was throwing darts at a steel plate. They were just bouncing off. And finally, I said, I'm out of this conversation. I gotta go. I'm done. So, you know, I couldn't take it personal, because it's not that person talking. It's not anymore. But know this, that in the last days perilous times will come. Where are we, guys? Are we in the last days? This section right here is what God was showing me. He says, I want you to, because remember, I told you I couldn't get any peace. I couldn't get to where I was praying. I couldn't. Man, my mind was going all over the place. Never has this happened before. But know this, that in the last days perilous times will come. For men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, proud, blasphemers. That one was a tongue twister. Boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers, without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness. This one is really interesting. Having a form of godliness but denying its power. From such people, turn away. And that's what I did. I got to a place where, you know, once I realized it was just getting worse, I just turned away and removed myself from the situation. For of this sort are those who creep into households and make captives of gullible women, loaded down with sins, led away by various lusts, always learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. And they can go both ways, women or men. Yeah, it works both ways. He says, yes, and all who desire to live godly. Did you hear that? All. Who's all? Are you an all? I'm an all. We're all all. All who desire to live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. But evil men and imposters will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But you must continue in the things which you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them. So regardless, he says it's going to get worse, and it's going to get worse, it's going to get worse, and it's going to get worse. But we're supposed to continue doing what we do. You know, we're not supposed to hunker down in our homes and wait for the Revelation 12 sign. We're supposed to continue doing what we're supposed to do. What are we supposed to do? Go into all the world and feed the sheep. Preach the gospel. That's what we're supposed to do. Be a light unto the world. Be an example of Jesus to people. Be the only Jesus that people may ever see their entire life. That's what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to continue doing it until he comes and picks us up and snatches us out of here. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, and for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. Preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and teaching. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine any longer. And that's where we are now. We're there. But according to their own desires, because they have itching ears, they will heap up for themselves teachers, and they will turn their ears away from the truth and be turned aside to fables. He says, do the work of an evangelist. Fulfill your ministry. And then he finishes off with, I've fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I kept the faith. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day. And not to me only, but to all of us. Sorry. That one kind of choked me up a little bit. But to all of us who have loved his appearing. And then there was a guy here, Demas. He says, Demas has forsaken me, having loved this present world. I feel you, Paul. Then there's another guy here, Alexander the coppersmith, did much harm to me. He said, may the Lord repay him according to his works. Ouch. I guarantee his end probably didn't. It didn't go well for him. He says, now he was in chains at this time. He says, at my first offense, no one stood with me, but all forsook me. May it not be charged against them. He lets them off the hook. He's sweet. But the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, so that the message might be preached fully through me, and that all the Gentiles might hear. Also, I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion. Hello. You know, we think we got it bad. They had to deal with lions. They had to deal with lions. And getting stoned to death. What do we deal with? Oh, somebody ridiculed me. He ridiculed me. Oh, they were dealing with lions. Getting stoned to death. Boiled. Crucified upside down. Man. And we complained. He says, and the Lord will deliver me from every evil work and preserve me for his heavenly kingdom. So, I just wanted to read there. That was where I felt like reading today. And, you know, I'm feeling really odd. I'm going to go into the gym, but I don't even feel like going today. But I've got to, because I've got to continue doing my job. I've got to keep doing. It's like I got several different ministries going. I got this one on YouTube that I do, and I love it. And then I got this one in the gym that I do, and then I get this one over at work that I do, and then I get this one, you know, where I go and preach on Sundays and stuff. And then I have just my daily life where I'm just out there in grocery stores and meeting people and doing things. It's like I've got six different ministries, and they're all a little different from each other, and they're similar at the same time. But yeah, that's it. I didn't really have anything more. It's 21 minutes. I'm just going to keep it short today. I do have a testimony, but I'm not going to tell it right now. Another day. Save for another day. So, I love you guys. I will talk to you later. Have a good day. Bye.